Keep the tank on first. Switch. And around. Stand so you're the same line. So your head all the way around. Butt push, go around the front of your heart. Up, down the front. Mimikaite, the contact, the turn. Everything in front of you, so your shoulders are in front of your partner. Turn. Again, raise your head and go around the front of your partner. So you stay connected to where the shoulder is, round it. Instead of going like so, as if to flatten the hand, so as he gets it, it's just responding to it. The back foot then goes offline, so when you turn around, you're looking the same way. So you shouldn't be standing where they're going to strike. You need to be offline. So when you turn, they're past you. But I want you to use the other hand. The other hand stays right in front of your face. Okay, so keep both hands like that, facing forward, in front of your face, turn around. Both hands. You see, keep that there, the contact. Okay? Again. Contact. This one, you use this shape. Okay, because that's where he's holding. He's holding from underneath, so that's the side you need to push. So his elbow goes up. Round. Hands free, so the arm is in front of you. So the movement now is this, not that. So leave this hand directly in front of you, pick them up. So as you pick them up, they come up with your elbow inside that, with your body inside that space. And don't use the other shape. You only use that if they're not, if they're holding you. So if they're here like, just raise your arm up naturally to your own head, but not in their space. So you don't do that. Your own head. Okay, as you go up, turn around. Alright? Okay, again. So, it's the same movement we just did when we went in, where you go around. Now, do the receiving. So he's going to hit that same hand as it comes towards you, hamni, receive it, turn your hips towards them. So as they wait to finish in the yokum, they come towards you. Okay. So the hand cuts again across the front of your face. You need to turn around. So you're rotating, not just stepping back. It's almost like you're changing hand. but you want to feel their shoulder come towards you, so you put your body in that space. So you're absorbing that. Use the other hand, always to make sure you protect your face. So that cuts down. Alright? Okay. Buck your head. Get the wind coming around. Let it hit. Turn. Turn back. Turn. Turn back. Turn. The other hand, your front of your face goes down. Front of your center. Turn around. Center. Right. Absorb. Don't stop them. Okay? Again. Let them work. Same side. Okay. Now give them the front as they come in that space. Other one. Thank you. So keep the palm open, so as you turn, the elbow bends, turn Zuke's body away from you. Just walk into that palm. Turn them away from you so you can see their back. And open, keep in front of you as you go back. Roll up. Match your hammy the same way, so everything's looking. That's you. Head. Same line as his body, but in front of him. So now he's going inside the space. Turn it over, they run along the same line as your arms. They're still pushing as you can bend, so they keep going the same way. They don't actually come to your shoulder, they go to your shoulder, run down your arm. So you push, so they keep going. Okay? Just do that one first.
Right.
Okay? And then we'll push it back going around. That's much easier. Alright, so we're gonna go round. Now in that position, as he goes around, set the back foot so he's going past you, and keep pushing along that same line, so you end up looking at him. One, start pushing, go behind him at the same time. So it's like you're passing each other, like you're going, doing that, but going around. Pass. Alright, but this one is always pushing, one underneath, the one controlling the head. Not just pulling towards you, it's pushing the same way. Okay? Okay, let's try again. Now let's bring it around. Stays flat, you can step back. But you want to see the line you're traveling on clearly. So this one turns over, you slide across so you can see the opposite shoulder. Move the way around. Okay. Step back. And right in your space. Don't push them back. What you want to do is cut up. So they should be underneath you, then go down. Slide your body in. Slide diagonal. Keep the space. So you need to get to make sure you have the space here. Elbow. Walk through. Step back. Body's going to look forward a little bit, so it's going to go one, and then as if you're going to walk forward at the same side, and then this side is going to go underneath you. So think of that as going like it's going to brush it by you, so you're going around it. So again, one, and then open it wide for the queso. So you're just going to keep like looking that way, and just keep going that way. So when you go across, keep going. Same way. Okay. One. On the right. One. Okay?
Hey, it's right.
Yeah. What's the person next to you? Because it comes out wide. So watch your spot. It's right. Case of it. This time he makes the show. Okay, so you do that, do that, down. From there, like you just did, but you're applying it. Okay. So you step across, down, and then open. So you're looking at that same line. Pick it up so you can see that, down. Change how I mean that same line, that same spot. One, down, up. Okay?
Let's try.
5 minutes. We run out of time.
And you use your body weight backward. Also, your thumb is down when you grab. If you grab with the thumb up, you're just pulling this way. Like that, you're using more muscle when you do this. So you slide, slide back, then this motion and this motion at the same time. So you use your body weight and you move. That's why you need your foot like that. If your foot is this way, you're going backward, you have no support, you're going to fall down. So you need this foot there, your knees about shoulder wide, then just this way.
Perfect.
going, put it a little lower on the elbow, but keep pushing this elbow inside, slide in. Use your body weight again, bad word. This way. So the other one was on this side. This one is towards the inside. Make sure your knee is not straight like that. So if you fall on it, you know, if you feel like this, it's dead hand. If I would do shionage, I would step in like this. Now, you grab, you step in the same way. Instead of drawing this way, come back. It's like if you go and hit in like that, and you were going backward this way. Now, you just fit it. Like many were doing before. So back in the knee, slide in. Same thing. You grab, you push it forward. The feeling is you hit, then turn like that. So make sure that this is important, that you not only go this way, right? The feeling is you hit in, so you use your hips like that. If I just go straight, then I go down, I don't use my hip. Here, when I will go down, I turn, so I... So from here, you use this motion. If I just go down, this is the same. Right? So, slide in, enter, you can switch your feet sometimes. You don't do a break fall, you just step over the leg. Step over my leg, and then you can roll forward. Right? So you have the choice if you don't. But if you don't do break fall, tell your partner before.
So I'm going up like this.
Slowly, so. And. This foot the front foot should bring you backward. But if you're over this foot, you cannot come backward anymore. So make sure all of your feet together, then. Then this tongue comes close to his wrist, the other hand covers the tongue. Then you enter with your shoulder to the elbow. You should be close to him. If I'm like this, he can pull me. Okay? So here. Then again, use your body weight. Right? So you turn. So you bring him to your center. Here to your center. Then. Change partner, but keep the beginners with advanced speed. Right. If you're like this, then your partner is as strong as you are, and maybe more. So when you finish, after you turn here, you should have break his balance. Then you shift. Okay. So when you move this, the wrist is there. You move around the wrist. You don't try to move his wrist. Right? So this is there, you move around. Then, so it's one like you do this exercise, you move around this point. When you do shionage, you move also around this point. Right? So here, if after you turn, he's still strong, then you move for nothing. So if you need to move him, then balance before you throw it. If he's not on balance, he won't fall. That's one. Okay. If he's like this and he's strong there, it's hard to move. So bring him forward, then move around this point. Keep him in front of you. Finger into your own elbow to stop the rotation of his arm. So to do that, I need the other hand, I grab the forearm and I twist it like this. As I do that, I push forward so this goes into my elbow. From here, he still rotates his body this way. He can turn like this. To stop that, you need to push his arm this way so he cannot rotate like this. But you do it with your upper part. So if you're sitting like that, his arm is coming towards you, so he can turn. So you need to move forward towards him. Then I like, but there's many ways to do it, but I like to grab my own elbow so I'm centered. Instead of sometimes if the partner is stiff or strong or whatever, and you end up this way. From here, push towards him and you just finish. When you do the pin, make sure that your elbows, these bones, not yours, not mine, but are close to your body. Right? If you go like this, if you're like that, then there's a space here. Huh? And when you do this motion, palm up, you're gonna feel like the elbows are coming into you. So this way, your partner has less chance to just slide like this. Okay, so when you move up, but they got your seat from the wheel, push, grab, forwards. Right?
Shoulder, not like this, otherwise you will fall down, or worse, you might fall on your foot and hurt your big toe.
Hey.
Hey.